you have a car, you may actually have automotive grade Linux in it, and it's being utilized in a number of different places and being enhanced along the way.
Yeah.
Could you talk about some of the changes that have been happening over the past year?
Sure.
I've heard that the containers and the VMs are sort of getting together these days.
That's right. So we one of the big things we did this year, I think it was around the May timeframe, we decided to merge two of our expert groups inside AGL. One of them was called Container and Service Mesh, which was being led by Amazon AWS. The second was called Virtualization Expert Group, which was being led by Panasonic. But because they were working on very complementary technologies, we decided to merge them and rename it Software Defined Vehicles. And I know SDV is, you know, big buzzwords. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of people are like wondering what the heck does it mean. I've actually tried to define what it means. I've actually done a keynote recently at Automotive Linux Summit where I walked through the slides. You can check that out on YouTube. But the point of this new expert group is that we want to utilize all the technologies we've already developed to bring the car to more of an IT world, meaning treat the car more like a server than it is today and simplify the management of the deployment and the upgrade of software. And the way we're doing that with this new SDV expert group is that we have a virtualization layer, so we can use open source hypervisors, or a car manufacturer can get a hypervisor from a commercial vendor. That's perfectly fine also. Mm-hmm. Then we have VirtIO, which is the virtualization of all the devices and the peripherals. And then we have containers. So those three key elements of this technology stack allows us to take advantage of the trend in the industry, which is the consolidation of the cockpit. So we now have, you know, very powerful SoC chips that have multi-core, lots of cores, and we need to utilize those cores. And so this consolidation of instrument cluster, heads-up display, and infotainment is a no-brainer, right? So those are three key functions in the cockpit that run on different processors today, different screens, you know. There's no reason why we can't combine all of those. So SDV is intended to really combine all of those functions on a single processor, but also make it easy to manage. And so what that means is you can run the infotainment, you can run the instrument cluster and the heads-up display in separate containers. And the idea is that you can now, you know, in the past, on in a traditional system, it's an embedded device. It's a hardware board, and the code is compiled specifically for that hardware board. So if you change a single line of code to fix a security problem, let's say, you need to recompile, re-download to flash, and reboot the whole thing. Under the futuristic model, the vision that we're thinking of is that, no, let's treat the car the same way the IT world treats servers, where if I need to fix an issue in a specific part of the system, like infotainment, or even you can break those up into even more specific containers, you can make an update just to that specific part and mm-hmm. push it back to the car. And so that's our vision for SDV. But it's further than that, because the analogy I like to use is that, you know, my current iPhone, I have an iPhone 15. It runs the latest version of iOS. That version of iOS also runs on my very old iPhone 8.
Mm-hmm.
And in the car industry, that's not the case. The version that was shipping 5-6 years ago is a completely different software than the version that is shipping today, and they don't tend to typically update those. There's no reason for that. There's no reason why they can't follow the Apple model, which is have a single software base that is based on AGL, and have it, if we abstract the hardware, the way we're talking about with this SDV expert group, we can have that same software image running on multiple generations of cars, as long as the processor's performant, you know, has enough performance for it,
mm-hmm.
no problem. And the car companies need to adopt this new way of thinking, and this is what the SDV work group is really all about.
Yeah. Okay. Now, the stuff that you're actually putting on top of this, there's a tool that you have called Flutter. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
Correct, yeah. So this is another great development in the past year. Flutter was or is a UI and application development toolkit
mm-hmm.
that is very analogous to Qt, because a lot of people know Qt in the industry. And Flutter was designed and open sourced by Google originally, and it was designed for mobile devices. Toyota took Flutter and made it automotive specific, embedded automotive specific. They added a lot of automotive features, landscape mode, things like that. And they took all that code and contributed that code back to AGL. Mm-hmm. So now we have like a million lines of code of Flutter, and we're the home of automotive Flutter. And why is that important? Well, first of all, it really puts us on par now with Android in terms of the ease of UI and ease of app development. Mm-hmm. And so it really, it makes it easier for application developers. But secondly, it also allows a manufacturer to easily skin the vehicle to their specific look and feel that they want for their brand, mm-hmm. More easily with Flutter than it would, you know, in the past with, like, let's say HTML5 or something. And so those are big developments, and we're the home of automotive Flutter.
Yeah. Well, great. Thank you for filling us in on what's been happening with Automotive Grade Linux.